walking down the street, everybody that you meet has an original point of view. And I say, hey, what a wonderful kind of day.
What was your favorite cartoon growing up?
Oh, that's a good question. My favorite cartoon growing up. Alright, so I got a few. And I think, you know, everybody who's along my age or maybe a year or two older than me will know this. There was Biker Mice from Mars. There was Bobby's World. There was... what other show? There was The Tick. I remember that. I remember The Mask, the movie The Mask. Jim Carrey, he had his own cartoon. Street Sharks, yo, Street Sharks was my ish. What else? Arthur was a good show. Arthur and DW reminded me of my little sister. And I'll say, yeah, those are my favorite cartoons. And of course, the classics, you know, Bugs Bunny, Looney Tunes, and all that good stuff. So I'll say, yeah. Open up your mind.
You and me, red. What's your favorite cereal?
Favorite cereal? Man, that's a hard one, bro. But I would say it's always been between, like, Apple Jacks and like, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Fruity Pebbles, and what's it called? Smacks? Smacks is it called? You know what, the frog on the thing? Dang it, I forgot the name. I think it's called Smacks. Kellogg's Smacks, I think it's called. Yeah, it's pretty good.
So who's your favorite superhero?
Favorite superhero is Superman. Superman, man. I know it's a pretty cliche thing to say, but you know, I just feel like Superman was one of the most misunderstood superheroes of his time, you know. Not to mention, you know, he was he could go undercover like that. All he gotta do is throw some glasses on and whoa, hey, where'd Superman go? I mean, just throw on some glasses, slick your hair back, and all of a sudden he's Clark Kent. No, but I think it's the fact of him knowing how much power and how much he could do, and the fact that he could take over the world if he wanted to, and he could do anything he ever wanted in life, but he never chose to do that. He chose to be a normal, regular person. He never really tried to take any credit for anything. He just liked to help people. He just liked to save people, and... who could take down Superman? When you hear of Superman, you never hear about a story of him dying or being indestructible. Yeah, I know there's kryptonite, but yo, I mean, everybody has their kryptonite. You know, everybody, whether it's women, whether it's drinking, whether it's going out, whether it's, you know, being lazy at certain times, whether it's their anger. I feel like all of us, we have our own form of kryptonite and things that veer us away from our path or kind of make us weaker than we normally are. But at the end of the day, we're all strong and we are superheroes on our own. And you never know how strong you gotta be until you have no choice but to do that. So, Superman that. Oh. Yeah. If you like what you hear, all fresh and new, white people, is a solo from Jock to you.
If you could take on one obscure job for one day, what would it be?
A And define obscure. What do you mean by that?
Like, you know, like sewage worker, you know, something like that.
Let me see if I had to take on an obscure job. You know, the thing is, like, growing up, I was gonna be a garbage man, yo. And a lot of people were like, "What?" I mean, they pay good money, man. They really do. Like, yeah, it's a nasty job. Yes, it's a hard working job. You know, like these people that work in the sewage system and but I would say, yeah, you know, garbage man working the sewage system. The dirtier the job, the better pay, man. So, and at the end of the day, a job is a job. Just as long as you are in my, and I lead you in the wrong way. Take you to the wrong place.